students, in this video we are going to discuss every one of the important property of the light, that is critical angle and as well as total internal reflection. Before, many properties of the light were discussed, that is refraction, reflection, interference, dispersion. This is one of the very important aspect of the light that we are going to discuss now. For that purpose, we are going to do the activity, and for that activity we are going to use the same apparatus what we used in the case of Snell's law. That is a prosectil, next one semicircular glass slab, next one protractor, scale, pencil, white paper and the remaining things. For that purpose we should draw the prosectil, and at the center of the prosectil we should place the semicircular glass slab. Now observe the activity what we did. In this video we are going to learn the properties of the light when it is travel from semicircular shape, that is from denser to rarer, that is from glass to air. In the before cases we studied the properties of the light whenever it is travel from air to glass, that is from rarer to denser. In this case the light is traveling from denser to rarer. Materials are, you already know the materials, this is prosircle, white paper is there, and at the same time semicircular glass disc, laser light, pins are there with us. Now I am going to pass the laser light first of all at an angle of 0 degrees. See, if the laser light is passes through an angle of 0 degrees, we can observe the laser light that is falling on my finger. We can observe that exactly at that direction only. I am going to put one more pin. Now this is case 1. In the case of case 1, angle I is equal to 0, angle R is also 0 approximately. Now we are going to move at an angle of 20 degrees. When the laser light is passing at an angle of 20 degrees, we can observe the direction of laser light at certain angle. See here, we can observe the laser light is falling on my finger here. So at that particular point, I am going to put the pin. That means in the second case, angle I is equal to 10 degrees, angle R is approximately 15 degrees. What does it mean? Whenever a light ray is traveling from denser to rarer, it is deviating away from the normal. Angle I is not equal to angle R. Now move on to the angle of incidence is 20 degrees. Angle of incidence is 20 degrees. What does it mean? The laser light is passing in this direction at an angle of 20 degrees. We can understand that the laser light should pass through the pin. Whenever it is passes through the pin, and angle of refraction, see here we can observe clearly at that particular point, I am going to place the pin. This means the laser light will must and should passes through the pin. We can understand the laser light is passing through the pin. Come to this third case, angle I is equal to 20, then angle R becomes approximately, this is the angle R. So how much it may be? 10, 20, 30, 40, means approximately 42. So angle R is equal to 42 degrees. Angle I is 20, angle R is 42 degrees. Then comes to the angle I is 30 degrees. Angle I is 30 degrees, means the laser light is passing at an angle of 30 degrees. Yeah, count from that, see here, we can observe the refracted ray. At this particular point, we can place the laser pin. See, we can observe the laser is passing on the pin. Now, in this case, what the case? First, 0 degrees is over. Second case, 10 degrees is over. Third case, 20 degrees is over. And in this case, angle I is equal to 30 degrees, angle R approximately 56 degrees. What does it mean? We are calculating the angle between the normal and as well as refracted ray. Now, come to the 40 degrees angle. See here, the laser light is passing through at an angle of 40 degrees. When the angle of incidence is 40 degrees, the light ray is taking angle 70. So angle I is equal to 40 degrees, angle R becomes 70. Now, if you consider the angle is there in between 40 and as well as 50. If you observe the angle of incidence is 50, see, we can observe the direction of the light ray is here. See, it is there on the pen. Means in this case, the light ray is traveling. If you put the light ray, it is this is. What does it mean? Whenever the angle of incidence I is equal to 50, the light ray never enter into the air, again enter into the glass. It is not enter into the air, enter into the glass. Now, if you observe in between 40 and as well as 50, we can observe the direction of the light ray is here. Means the light ray is grazing the interface of both air and as well as glass. Means whenever a light ray is traveling from rarer to denser, it up to certain angle, it enter into the rarer. At certain angle, it grazes the interface of both air and as well as glass. Beyond that angle, again the light ray enter into the denser. This angle where the light ray grazes the interface is called critical angle. The angle at which the light ray again enter into the denser is called total internal reflection. Total internal reflection. This one we can explain clearly through a table and as well as on the board now. Already we did the activity now. From the activity we got the table. From the table we are going to draw graphical representations. In the case 1, angle I is equals to 0, angle R is also 0. Means when the light ray strikes the surface at 90 degrees, there is no refraction. Either it is travel from denser to rarer or from rarer to denser. Now, come to the second case. Angle I is 10 degrees. Then angle R becomes 15 degrees. That means the light ray is deviated away from the normal whenever it is traveling from denser to rarer, and angle R is greater than angle I. Now come to the next case. Angle I is 20 degrees. From the table we can understand that angle I is 20 degrees. Then angle R becomes 40 degrees. That means here the light ray, whenever it is traveling from denser to rarer, the light ray is deviating away from the normal. Here also we can prove that angle R is greater than angle I. Let us, like 30 degrees, whenever it is reaches approximately 40 degrees or beyond 40 degrees also, if you observe, the light ray is grazing the interface of both rarer and as well as denser, grazing the interface of rarer and denser, such angle of incidence is called critical angle. Once again, the definition of critical angle is the angle at which the light ray travels from rarer to denser, it grazes the interface of both rarer and denser is called critical angle. Now, come to the next case, means beyond the critical angle, from the table we can understand that beyond the critical angle means more than 40 degrees, 50 degrees, 60, 70, 80, up to even 85 degrees also. Whenever the light is traveling from denser to rarer, beyond the critical angle, the light never enter into the rarer, again enter into the denser. That phenomena light is called total internal reflection. See the definition of total internal reflection. The definition of total internal reflection is when the light travels from denser to rarer beyond the critical angle, the light never enter into the rarer. It again enter into the denser. This phenomena is called total internal reflection. And once again, the definition of critical angle is when a light travels from denser to rarer, at a particular angle of incidence, light grazes the interface of denser and rarer. Such angle of incidence is called critical angle. So from this activity, we understood the topic of critical angle and as well as total internal reflection. We should remember one thing, students. This process can be taken place only the light is traveling from denser to rarer. Now final conclusions are, when the light is traveling from denser to rarer, angle of refraction is greater than the angle of incidence, number one. And number two, at a particular angle of incidence, light grazes the surface. Number three, beyond the critical angle, light never enter into the rarer, again enter into the denser. That phenomena is called total internal reflection. From this video, we can understand a capacity of to understand the critical angle and as well as total internal reflection. In the next video, we are going to discuss what are the different examples of the total internal reflection, that is the formation of mirage, brightening of the stars, twinkling of the stars, flickerance of the diamond, and so on. Thank you.